Praise the Lord, everyone. Welcome to part two of our series called A Place Called Lodibar. In this week's segment, the topic is, Are You All Right Today? And I just want to ask the question, how many of us have actually asked your neighbor, Are you all right today? How many of us actually called our neighbor to find out if they are all right, how are you doing? Last week we spoke on persons being in Lodibar and it is not of their own fault. We have many persons, right, that might have been abused as a child. They are molested. They are battling with different things in the mind in their everyday lives, like drug addiction, homosexuality, adultery, alcohol addiction, acute depression, something that has affected their mind, right? Something that has caused them to not sleep at night, something that has crippled them from being who God has intended them to be, right? These are the things that a lot of persons are struggling. They fight with these things on a daily basis. They may not blurt it out or come and say to somebody, but we have a lot of persons that are miserable, unhappy. They are frustrated, always moody, some full of anger. You're just not sure, why is this person always so angry? These are some of the things that contribute to that. They are jealous, they are full of jealousy, right? Something that has them in what I will say a psychological prison, right? And there seems to be no way of escape for them. They seem to have no way to get out of this psychological prison that they are in. Some of them, they cannot talk about it because they are ashamed, you know, of their particular struggle or situation that they are going through. They are embarrassed and worried that probably you, myself, or whoever they might speak to about it may not understand, right, or may even attempt to understand what they are going through. They are worried that some people may talk about them, right, about their struggle. Right, but there's something that I want us to understand, especially in church as children of God, that church is a hospital, right? It's not just there for us to come on a Sunday or a Bible study or at a youth gathering or a fasting service or which are our services to just come and sing songs and give praises to God, but it is to fulfill the need that man have. When the spiritual aspect is over, there is the physical aspect that we face, the mental health, the depression, the other things that we may face that the physical man struggles with. So the church is a hospital that is supposed to help persons get through these things, right? Have you ever realized that probably you might be sitting next to somebody, a church sister that you might know that you might sat next to in church last week Sunday, right? That they might got beat up before, right? Before they even came to church, where physically their struggles, right? Probably they have demonic warfare as well going through. They might have been beat up, right? You might not know that person is afraid of their own child at home, right? You have parents that struggle with their own child. Somebody that can't get over something that happened to them when they were younger as a child, whether it be abuse, right? Whether it be verbal abuse, physical abuse, right? You don't know what they're going through and they cannot get over it as a child. Right, there are things that they go go through, right? And you may say to yourself, what? Not the people that I sit with or I sit next to at church or at work or wherever it might be. Not them. I know them. They don't look that way. It will not always appear that way to you. It will not always show up that way to you, right? You have persons that are going through it. You know what you want to know, or sometimes the persons let you know what they want you to know, but sometimes we do not know and we do not understand, right, that the church is full of people from a place called Lodibar. A lot of persons are in a place called Lodibar. But Paul said something interesting in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 Corinthians, sorry, 1 verses 27 to about 30 or 31, sorry. But God has chosen the foolish things of this world to put shame to the wise, right? And God has given the weak things of the world to put shame to the things which are mighty. 28 say, and the base things of the world and the things which are despised God has chosen, and the things which are not, to bring to nothing the things that are. 29, that no flesh should glory in his presence. It is because of him you are in Christ Jesus, who will become for us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. That as it is written, he who glories, let him glory the Lord, right? People are afraid, right? People are afraid to come out of their Lodibar. People are afraid of the result of getting help from others, right? People are afraid to ask for help. People are worried that they will get put down, right? These are genuine concerns of persons that are going through their different struggles, that they are going through their Lodibar, right? They are fearful that we talk about them, that we may insult them, because you do have persons that will insult somebody, right, that is trying to explain to them what they are going through, right? They fear ridicule. They fear that, you know, they might be talked about at church. These are genuine things that persons go through in their Lodibar, in the church of God. These are real issues that persons face. So call a neighbor. Just pick up your phone after you are through with this prayer meditation. Call a brother. Call a sister. Just find out how are they doing. Give them a word of encouragement. Let them know that God still loves them, that you as their church brother and their church sister still love them. You still care for them. Persons out there, they sometimes just need to hear a word. You don't have to be around the podium to give a word to somebody, to reach out, to touch somebody's soul. Just pick up your phone, give them a call. If you're not the type of person who likes to call, we have WhatsApp, we have text messages. Send them a message, send them a voice note. Say, hey brother, you run on my mind today. Hey sister, you're on my mind today. God bless you, hope you're okay. You're still in my prayers, and whatever you might be struggling with, God is in the midst. You don't know how much that can do for someone. So just remember to ask yourself, right? Have I asked any of my brothers? Have I asked my neighbor, are you all right today? Hallelujah. Just to advise you that for those of us who are watching, for prayer or counseling, you can email us at fbgtmountroyal@gmail.com. You can call, WhatsApp, or text us at 876-812-2185. That's 876-812-2185. Brothers and sisters, I know that we're facing it on a daily struggle, but continue to trust God. He is going to work it out for you. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we come to you now. Oh God, the only God that knows all things. Oh God, you hold time and season in your hands. Oh God, you call light out of the darkness. Oh God, we come to that God today. Oh God, to lift our hearts and our hands and say, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh upon every viewer, God, that is watching this today. Fall afresh, God Almighty. Oh, upon everyone that is in their personal lodi bar, God Almighty, that, oh God, is afraid to reach out to someone because they are fearful of the results. They're fearful, oh, that they might get put down, that, oh, they might be insulted, God. They're fearful, God, for their name to be going around, God Almighty, for their struggle, God, instead of getting help, God, someone is gossiping about them. Oh God, Spirit of the living God, I pray that you fall afresh upon them. Every ill will of the adversary, we put it under our feet in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh upon that person in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of the living God, I pray right now, God Almighty, oh God, that you break the fetters, you break the chains over their lives, God. You break the bondage, the yokes, God Almighty. Oh God Almighty, the effects of Lodibar is no longer on them, God. I reverse it, I command it to be gone from their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God Almighty, bless our church, bless our ministry, God Almighty. Cover, oh God, Mount Royal under your blood, Jesus Christ. Remember, oh God Almighty, our, oh God, session on Saturday, God Almighty. Oh God, on mental health, God Almighty, on also on your diet, God Almighty, and what we eat, God Almighty, God, bless it, God. May it be a blessing to someone else, God Almighty. Bless the ministers, God, the saints, God Almighty. Bless our pastor and overseer of Mount Royal. Cover her under your blood. Oh, God Almighty, bless the family of churches, the PGT family of churches, God, our sister churches. Cover them under your blood, God Almighty, God. Even in a time as this, God, oh, God, the church will prosper, God Almighty. Oh, God, we will stay connected, God, not only with you, but with one another, God, while we're socially distant, God Almighty. Your ministry will prosper in such a time as this. Someone will be released from their lodi bar in such a time as this. Oh God, have your own way, Jesus Christ. Bless, keep, cover, God Almighty. Have your own way, God, and I call it done today. I call it done, and I believe by faith that it is done in someone's life today. In Jesus' name, amen. Brothers and sisters, whatever you're facing, God can fix it. The effects of Lodibar won't always be over your life. Just trust God and trust God's timing. Believe that it will work out in your life, and I believe by faith that it will. God bless you all. Tune in again next week for part 3 to our series, A Place Called Lodibar. God bless you in Jesus' name.
I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed. This more than